Okay, hello and welcome to GE103. Today we are going to be finishing chapter number 5, which if you recall is the chapter on pointers and arrays. So up till now, to recap quickly, we have seen that a pointer is a special kind of variable that instead of holding regular values, holds the memory address of a separate variable, right? So we can have a pointer to an integer, pointer to a character, pointer to a floating point, and so on. One of the strengths of pointers, as we have seen, is that they work very well with arrays. So if you make a pointer point to the first element of an array, then using the array you can using the pointer, you can walk through the array and then you can perform certain operations on it. As such, the relationship between pointers and arrays is a very close one, because we know that the name of an array is a pointer to its first element. So if you recall, in the previous class we had looked at a special kind of an array, which is an array of pointers. So what we mean here is that each element of this array contains a pointer to a specific kind of variable. So in the previous class we had done one example of this, which was the simple program that takes in command line arguments, right? So we provided those command line arguments at runtime, and then what we did was we did a simple version of echo. Whichever arguments we provided at the runtime through the command line, those were output back to the screen. So what we are going to do today is we are going to look at a slightly bigger, slightly more complicated case study or program, which illustrates the real strength of an array of pointers. So this program, what it is going to do is it is going to sort a set of lines. So as the slide says, this is a basic version of Unix command sort. So we do know that the sort operation is one of the most common operations in computing. So what is going to happen here is we are going to be provided a set of lines which we'll input from the command line, and then the output of this program will be set of sorted lines. So if the input is these three lines, first line is DEFGI, second is JKLM going all the way to T, and then the third line is ABC. So the output will be these set of lines in a sorted manner. So which means that when we print out, first we'll be printing ABC, then the DEF up till I, and then J up till T. All right, so now as you see on this slide, we are essentially showing what the input and output is going to be like. So if you see the top figure here, what we have is we've got the three lines, and towards the left what you see is our main data structure, which is an array of pointers, right? So this is an array of capable of storing three character pointers. So if we the way we would declare this is char star A3. So the value of A0, we're using the array notation. The value of A0 would be a pointer to the line DEFGHI. Value of A1 would be a pointer to line JKL going up to T. And finally, the value of A2 would be a pointer to the line ABC. So towards the left, what we see is an array of pointers, each pointing to a particular line. What we see towards the right is what the output is going to look like. So this one now, what you will see here is that the different pointers have changed, they've shifted. So because now we want to print in sorted order, so the first pointer will of course point to ABC. Second pointer will point to DEFGHI, and finally third pointer will point to JKLMNOPQRST. So as you can see, what we are doing here is we are not moving the lines at all. The lines stay where they are. The only thing that we are moving is we are moving the pointers. So of course, as you can see, moving pointers is a lot more efficient than moving the lines themselves, because the lines are of various lengths, and when we copy them to a different place, those operations will take longer than if we're just pointing the if we are just moving around the pointers. So once again, to recap, what we are going to be doing here is moving the pointers, not the lines themselves. Now the next question is, how do we swap two pointers or two elements of this array of pointers? So the second picture on this slide shows how to do that. And if you recall, this procedure is very similar to when you are swapping two elements of an array of characters, or swapping two elements of an array of integers. So this is a piece of code. Here we are given, let's say, an array of two characters. So each will be storing a pointer. So char star A2. So A0 is pointing to a particular line. We have shown that in that rectangle, and A1 is also pointing to a different line. So let's say the machine for line number 1, it fixes the address at 100, and then let's say for line number 2, it fixes the address at 104. So of course it could be different. This is just for illustrative purposes. Now note that the addresses don't have to be contiguous to each other. So address 1 could have been 100, and address 2 could have been 2000, right? Addresses don't have to be contiguous. Now, the effect that we want is, after the swap, we want A0 to point to the line that A1 is pointing to, and A1 to point to the line that A0 is pointing to. So we want a swap. So the code is given on the right. So first, of course, we'll need a temporary variable, so which we have as char star temp. So now what we do is, the piece of code that runs is temp is equal to A of 0. So A of 0 initially has 100, which is the memory location where line 1 starts. So temp is equal to 100. That's the first line of code. Second, what we do is A0 is equal to A1. So which means now A0 will contain address 104. So importantly, now A0 will be pointing to line 2. Okay. And now all that needs to be done is we need to copy temp to A1. So we say A1 is equal to temp, which means now A1 will contain the address 0, which means now A1 will point to line 1. So here all we've done is we've swapped the pointers. The lines, they remain where they are. So we can see that swapping of pointers is very similar to swapping of two integers. So this shows that the data structure in question will be an array of pointers. So each pointer will point to a text line, which is nothing but a string of characters. After the sort, the first pointer of the array is going to point to the smallest text line alphabetically. Likewise, second pointer will point to next smallest, and then so on. So just like they would appear in a dictionary. So once again, note that we are just going to be moving around the pointers. Pointers will be the members of that array, and we're not moving the lines themselves. Now, one question that we have to face is, how are we going to sort the lines? So we are going to be using quicksort, which, if you recall, we recently talked about. It's an example of a recursive algorithm, which means it keeps on calling itself every time with a smaller array. So if you recall, what that algorithm or the quicksort procedure does is, at each stage, it divides the array into two parts. And the middle element is a pivot, and then it applies certain operations, and such that once those operations are finished, all the elements smaller than the pivot appear to the left, all the elements larger than the pivot appear to the right. And then recursively quicksort is applied to the left subarray and the right subarray. So at the end, what we get is we get a sorted array. So one main operation there was, if you recall, in quicksort was to compare different array elements. So specifically to compare the array elements with the pivot, right? So what we did was we calculate the pivot, which is embed element, then we shift it towards the left end, and then for all the rest of the elements we compare with the pivot, and then whether it's smaller or larger we swap or we don't swap. So those in that example we had an array of integers, right? So we could easily use the less than operator for comparing. Here what has changed is now what we are comparing is, we are not comparing integers, but we are comparing lines. We are comparing a set of characters. So now, of course, the less than operation is not going to work. So fortunately, we can use the string comparison function, which also we have coded. So that function will tell us, whether one line is as it would appear in a dictionary, whether one line comes before or is the same or after second line, right? So we will compare two lines using the string comparison function. So just to recall, pointers to the two lines will be passed to string comparison function. And let's say P1 points to line 1, P2 points to line 2, right? So if line 1 is less than line 2, meaning if line 1 will come before line 2 in a dictionary alphabetical sequence, then string comparison returns a negative value. If they're equal, it returns 0, and if line 1 appears after line 2 in a dictionary, then string comparison returns a positive value. So to state once again, the key concept here is that when two out of order lines have to be exchanged, the pointers in the pointer array are exchanged, not the text lines themselves, right? So we saw that with quicksort, when we have two out of order array elements, we have to swap them. So same thing is happening here. The only difference is the array elements are not integers, but they are pointers to text lines. As such, they are variables, so they can be swapped. Note that exchanging or swapping the lines themselves would require a lot of memory, because when you swap, then you have to copy to a temporary block of memory, right? And then depending on the size of the line, that could be substantial, right? So you're copying many characters, whereas here you're only copying a single variable. So using pointers, this memory can be saved. So this is an example of a scenario where having a pointer based solution is a lot more faster, a lot more efficient memory wise. Alright, so what we do now is we outline the main steps of this program, main steps of this algorithm. So those are pretty simple, three actually. First of all, we need to read all the lines of the input. Second step is we need to sort those lines, so we are using quicksort. And third is we have to print the lines in order, we have to print the sorted lines. So of course, note that once we read a particular line, we also have to store it somewhere, which means we have to reserve memory. And once we have that memory where we store the line, then we have to make an appropriate pointer point to it. So we have to do this for each and every line that we read. Okay. So once we have that, then we sort, and then finally we print the all the lines in a sorted manner. So a couple of important aspects. In this program, a lot of the functions which we are going to be using, we've already coded those before. So we'll just be reusing them. So we will read the lines using getLine. So if you recall, getLine function from chapter 1, that will be used to read each new line from the input, from the command line. Now, once you read a line, you have to store it somewhere. So for that, we need to reserve memory. So for that, we'll use previously discussed alloc function. So that will allocate memory for all the lines. Next, once we read a line, we make an appropriate pointer point to it. So this pointer is a member of our main data structure, which is an array of pointers. Next, the sorting of the lines will be done by quicksort. Again, quicksort has been discussed earlier. So of course, we need to make some small changes to it because the earlier version worked with an array of integers. This one needs to work with an array of pointers, each pointer pointing to a text line. So we'll see that surprisingly, the changes that have to be made to quicksort are going to be very, very minimal. Okay. So now we'll discuss the program bit by bit. And note that the complete program is available on Moodle. So you can go through it, you can execute it, and you can play around with it. So now we discuss function by function this detailed program. Okay, so here is our main function. So this is our driver, our main, which is going to be calling all the other different functions. So as you can see, stdio, of course, for input output, header file, string.h for some string operations. Max lines is 5000, which means we are putting a limit to the number of lines we can read, and that limit is 5000. Okay, so we can only read a finite number of lines, which is 5000. Next, we have our main data structure, as we have discussed, an array of character pointers. So that is called a line pointer. So we have char star line pointer and then max lines. So it is capable of storing 5000 pointers, each pointing to a separate line. Next function is read lines. So this is going to be reading all the lines from the input. Okay, and it's going to be, once it's done reading, it is going to return the number of lines read. Okay, so note that number of lines read will be quite important, because when you're sorting or when you're printing, you need to know, you know, how many lines you print. Next function is write lines. So what it will do is print all the sorted lines in this case. So it will go to the first element of the array, line pointer, and then using percentage s, it is going to print that line. And then it goes to the next print stat line, and so on and so forth. Next function we have is, of course, quicksort. So here, this is very similar to the previous version of quicksort. Only thing is, instead of being fed an array of integers, it is going to be input an array of pointers. And then, of course, left and last will be the indexes of the beginning and end of that array. So that notation will remain the same. So first, what we have, as you can see in the main, is we have a variable which tells us what is the number of lines read. And then when we call read lines, it is going to keep reading all the lines from the input. Okay. And it is going to tell us, once it's done reading, it is going to tell us how many lines we have read. So we copy that into n lines, and then assuming that we have an input, we've read a line, then we can go ahead and sort it, and then we can write or output it. Okay. If we exceed the limit we have set for number of lines read, so of course, in that case, it will give an error saying that input is too big to sort. So because we know the number of lines, if the number of lines is over 5000, then of course we'll give an error saying the input is too big to sort. So here we have our getLine function, our old friend from chapter number 1. And if you recall, what this function does is reads the next line from the input. And we know that the way input is set up in C is that each line is terminated with a new line character, right? So what this getLine function will do is it reads the next line from the input, okay, character by character. So you can see it's using getchar, and as it keeps on reading a character of the current line, it stores that in an array of called S. Okay, so it will read all the characters of the line, including the terminating null, including the new line, and all of those characters will be stored in an array S. And not only that, it will also return the length of the line which is just read. So this is a recap of get line. Next we have the alloc function. So this we have also covered in one of the earlier classes when we were on the same chapter on pointers. So what this function does is every time you call it, you are essentially requesting a block of memory, which is nothing but an array of characters of a certain size. And what this function is doing is allocating that memory to you of consisting of or capable of storing that many characters. And it is also returning a pointer to the beginning of that block. Okay, so that is the allocation part. And once you're done with that memory, then of course you can free it so that it can be used by other applications, other programs. So what is happening is it's got an array of characters of a certain size. Here the maximum available space is 10,000. Of course, can be increased, right? Once you request an array of certain size is n, it first sees whether enough memory is available. Your request is within bounds enough that whatever number of elements or characters you've requested, that a block capable of storing that many number of characters exists. Has to be a contiguous block, and if it does, it returns a pointer to the beginning of that block. So now that you have the pointer to the beginning of the block, you can now store characters in it. Okay, now assuming if sufficient memory is not available, it will return null. Okay, so when it satisfies the request successfully, it returns a pointer to the beginning of the block. So it means it returns an address. And when the request is unsuccessful because sufficient memory is not available, then it will return something which is guaranteed not to be an address. So something which signals unsuccessful termination of the function. So in this case, null or zero is a good value to have because it can be guaranteed never to be a memory address. So this is the alloc. All right, so now that we have discussed or we have revised get line and alloc functions, now we are ready to discuss the code for read lines. Okay. So what this function is doing is using get line, it's going to read the next line from the input, and it is going to reserve enough memory for storing that line. And then once that is done, it will make one of the members of the array of pointers to point to that line. So first, so that array of pointers is called 9PTR, right? And it is being, the index is being manipulated by number of lines, which is an int. So what it needs to do is the first line it reads, pointer to that line will go into line pointer 0. Second line that it reads, pointer to that second line goes into line pointer 1. Third line pointer 2, and so on and so forth. So for the index of line pointer, as you can see from this piece of code, for the index we are using n lines. So initialize to 0, of course, and then every time we read a new line, make a pointer point to it and increment n lines. So this is the function. So a couple of integers which we declare. The argument to the function is the array of pointers, because that's needed for copying a pointer to that line with a member of line pointer. And then max lines, because we can only read certain number of lines. So if this max lines is more than 5000, then of course we have to print out an error. We cannot proceed further. Some other some variables needed: int len. Len is for the length of the next line read, right? And lines is number of lines read. So every time we read a new line, and lines is increased. And finally, when we are done reading, and lines is returned back to main. Okay. So every time we call read lines, it's going to read all the lines of the input. And for reading each line, it uses getLine. So nLines is zero, of course. Other thing you have is a pointer. So we'll soon see what it's used for. And we also have an array of characters, line. Index for that is maxLen. So that is 1000, which means the length of a particular line cannot go beyond 1000. So nLines is zero, of course. And then when we say while len is equal to getLine, line max line greater than zero. So as long as we have a valid line to read. So note that even a blank line with no characters still has a new line in it. And the length of that is still one. Okay, so now we call getLine, right? And then what it does is reads the next line from input, puts it into array S, and here line, the line array is an alias for that. So line is an alias for S now. So using line, we can manipulate S, and max length of course is 1000. Right. So it reads and returns the length of the line. So while the length is greater than zero, while we have a line to read, now if a number of lines is greater than or equal to max lines, right, you have to return minus one to main, right? So which means it's an error. You cannot process that many number of lines. So if number of lines is greater than or equal to max lines, or p is alloc of len is equal to null. So when you're calling alloc, let's say if sufficient memory is not available, so note that the value returned is a null pointer. So null pointer means for that particular line, you could not reserve memory, which means you're essentially out of memory. So when you're out of memory, then also the operation aborts. So if either of these two situations occur, then of course you return minus one, program aborts. Otherwise, if you have sufficient memory, number of lines is less than maximum allowed. Okay, so then you can run the algorithm. So with the else, so first thing you do is you get rid of the new line character. So line minus one is equal to null. Okay. Next, what you do is a string copy p of line. So this is a string copy function, and this will just copy the pointers. So now what will happen is p will have the value of line. So line again, if you recall, is an alias for the first element of this array. So line and ampersand line zero are equivalent. So here what you're saying is p is equal to ampersand line zero, right? Which means the address of the first array element of line, which is the first character in that line. Now p points to that. Okay. So now all you have to do is make this p point to the appropriate pointer and line pointer, right? So when you read the first line, n lines is of course zero. And now if p points to that line, wherever in memory it's stored, so let's say it's starting from 1000. So p is equal to, is going to be 1000. And then the code that will execute is line pointer zero plus plus is equal to 1000. So now line pointer zero, first pointer of that array of pointers points to line number one, and then plus plus postfix. Likewise for second line, again, when you read the second line, again, its address may be different, let's say 10,000. So then that is copied to P, right? And then now the effect will be line pointer one plus plus is equal to 10,000. So now the second pointer in this array of pointers points to the second line, and then that process keeps on happening. And once you are done reading lines, okay, then you get out of the else right? So then the while will, you get out of the, you know, while loop, you stop reading, and then finally you return the number of lines. So now we look at how we output the line. So we have not sorted them yet. The sort algorithm, we'll soon, we're going to discuss that. So for now, let's assume that the lines are sorted and we have to print the set of sorted lines. So here, pretty much the only thing that needs to be done is the contents of, using the contents of line pointer, array of pointers, we have to print all the lines, right? So what we need to do is go to line pointer 0, right? So there we'll have the pointer to the first line, sorted one. So we print that, and then line pointer 1 will point to the next smallest. We print that, line pointer 2, next smallest, and so on. And the last value of I will contain the largest line alphabetically wise, and we have to print that. So printing is not a problem, definitely. It's a very small piece of code, as you can see. So we're just printing the array, line pointer 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And here each element is, each element of the array is a pointer to the appropriate line. And a pointer is what printf expects when you use the percentage s. And once it gets that pointer, it prints the complete line. So we just print using percentage s specifier, we print line pointer 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. So we know how many lines we have to print because the number of lines we have read, that is n lines. Okay. So the first version is uses the array or the index notation, and the second version uses the pointer notation. This is similar to the echo program, where we could write, we could print the array of pointers using two different ways. One is using array notation, and the other is using pointer notation. So first one is array notation, and version 2 is pointer notation. So here all we're doing is, so see what we have here, star line pointer plus plus. So once again, if we just talk about line pointer, right, without any indexes, any brackets, so that is just an alias for the memory location of the first element of the array. So line pointer is syntactically equal to ampersand line pointer of 0, right? So memory address of the first element, right, which is a pointer to the first element, and then when we dereference it, so what we get is the actual contents of line pointer 0, right? So contents of line pointer 0, of course, are pointer to the appropriate line. So with percentage s, we can print that line. And then we do plus plus. So now the pointer exceeds and points to the next element of the array line pointer. So now pointing to line pointer 1. And then again, we dereference, get the contents, print the line. So both of the versions will work. You can choose whichever one is more preferable, that's more convenient to you. Okay, so now we discuss this quick sort function, and what this will do is it's going to sort the line pointer array. And as we discuss, what it is going to do is it is just going to move the pointers around, not the lines themselves. So which means that once it's done, once quick sort is executed, then the first element of line pointer will point to the smallest line. And second pointer of line pointer array will point to second smallest, and then so on and so forth. And finally, the last pointer of line pointer array will point to the largest line alphabetically wise. So here, if you compare this with the quick sort of the previous chapter, so in the previous chapter, we were working with an array of integers. Here we are working with an array of pointers. So if you compare to the previous one, you'll see that very little has changed here. The only thing that has changed is instead of saying vi is less than vLeft, we are doing a string comparison between vi and vLeft, because both VI and VLEFT, they contain pointers, and both are pointers to text lines. So string comparison will be ideal in this case. So the effect of VI is less than VLEFT, we are getting from string comparison VI VLEFT. So the assumption is both VI and VLEFT are pointing to specific text lines. In fact, if you see, the rest of the code is exactly the same. So reason for this is whether you have an array of integers or whether you have an array of pointers, the array notation will work equally well for both cases. For the array of integers case, V0 will be 10, V1 will be 12, for example, V2 will be 6, V8 will be 100, and so on. For an array of pointers, V0 will be a pointer to one line, V1 will be a pointer to another line, V2 to another line, V8 to another line. So in short, for both kinds of arrays, the array notation will work equally well. So rest of it is pretty much the same. As you can see, swap is a key operation which we had when we have two elements which are out of sequence, we swap them, right? So if VI is less than VLEFT, then we swap, otherwise we don't swap. So here that same thing happens, and in one of the earlier slides we had seen how using similar code we can swap two pointers. So because when we're swapping VI and VLEFT, what we're doing is we are swapping two pointers. So if you go to that earlier slide, you can see how using pretty much the similar code we can swap the pointers. The only change that happens is the temp that we have, that is now going to be a pointer, right? And all our operations are pointer operations. So when we're copying, let's say VI is equal to VJ, so we're not copying integer values, but we're copying addresses, right? So rest of the program, quicksort, remains exactly the same. Right, so this is the last part of it. This just shows the swap operation, and what it will do is interchange or swap VI and VJ. So as you can see, it's very, very similar to the previous version of swap. Only difference is char V is replaced with char star V to indicate an array of pointers. Or I'm sorry, int V is replaced with char star V to indicate an array of pointers. Int temp is replaced with char star temp, right? Because temp has to contain an address, so it has to be a pointer variable. And the rest of the code is same, but the only thing is now this copying of memory addresses, copying of pointers is being done. So previous case, when we said temp is VI, then VI is an integer and that get copied to another integer temp. Here, when we say temp is equal to VI, VI contains a pointer to a suitable line, and that is being copied to temp. VI is VJ again, copying pointers. VJ is temp again, copying pointers. So this is an example of a larger program. And as mentioned before, the complete program is available on Moodle. So all of you should download it, run it, and go through it carefully line by line. And of course, do let me know in case you have any questions. I would recommend that you do focus on how the various functions are being called and what are the function arguments. So for example, when we are calling read lines, the first argument that read lines expects is the array of pointers, line pointer. Right. Second argument it expects is max lines, which we know bounds the number of lines we can read, which is 5000. So inside main you will see read line is being called with line pointer and comma max lines. Right. So likewise, get line will be called again with certain arguments, which so you can go through that. And one of the arguments will be the array s into which it will copy. Likewise for write lines, arguments, first argument it obviously expects is the array of pointers, right? And then the second argument it will expect is number of lines, because that will tell us, you know, for how long it should, or how many lines is it supposed to print. So in main, it is being called with a line PTR, right, which is a pointer to the array of pointers, and comma and lines, again, number of lines read. So within write lines, the way the arguments are equated is char star line pointer is equal to line pointer, right? So note that both are local to each other, they become aliases, although the name is the same. And again, end lines is equal to end lines, both local, even though name is same. Okay. And also note for quick sort. So what quicksort expects is first argument is pointer to the array that needs to be sorted. Okay, so in this case it's an array of pointers. So first argument is char star v, right? And then the other two are the beginning and end indexes of the array. So when you call quicksort for the first time, int left beginning index is 0, right? Of course, and int right last index is n minus 1. And then for the recursive calls, the values will change. So there will be different values, right? So the arguments are char star v and then int left and int right for quicksort. It's not returning anything, so return type is void. Calling from the main, first argument is line pointer, pointer to the array of pointers. So pointer to a pointer. So line PTR, so char star v is equal to line PTR. So V becomes an alias for line PTR. Both line PTR and V being array of pointers, right? Left is equal to I. So first time we call it, left will be, of course, 0. Index of the first array element of V or line PTR. And right will be, of course, n minus 1. N here is a number of lines read, which is n lines. So n lines minus 1 will be right. Finally, for swap, the arguments are char star v. So you do have to specify the array of pointers. And then you have to specify the two indexes that you want to swap. So let's say you want to swap vi and vj. So then I, comma j. So that is being provided. And swap is happening many times. First is swap v left, left plus right by 2. Right? And then at other locations also swap is happening. All cases, first argument is array of pointers. And second and third arguments are the indexes of the array elements that you want to swap. In this case, both will be pointers to, you know, specific lines of text. Okay, so do pay special attention to the function arguments, how they're getting equated and what is the effect. In most cases, one function argument in the call function becomes an alias for the function argument in the calling function. Okay, so do go through the program very carefully. It's a substantial amount of program, a significant amount of code, although a large chunk of the code has been reused. So for getline, code has been reused. Likewise for alloc, it's been reused. String comparison, again, we are reusing the piece of code. So the amount of new code written is still not that much. So please go through it and let me know in case of any questions. You can send me email. And with this, we finish the chapter on pointers. So chapter number 5, pointers and arrays, is finished. And the next chapter, which we will cover, will be another important one. Chapter 6, which is called structures. So together, these this chapter on pointers and the next chapter on structures will be very crucial to our subsequent discussion on different kind of data structures.